what an axe. G'day, it's Bergs, and this is the Cielo Mar, which I believe is something sea sky in Spanish, and it is built by my friend Ray Carlton, who lives at a place called The Basin here in beautiful Victoria, Australia. And this guitar, well, it's surf green, you can see that. It's a little thicker than your standard Tele or Strat. It's got a lovely cream binding. The wood is called Myrtle, and Myrtle is a relatively local hardwood. It's got a great tone. The neck is a sort of a generic Telecaster all parts neck. Or actually, it's not really Telecaster, is it? We reckon it's a 9.5-inch radius, medium frets, beautifully rounded shoulders. Mick Brierley has done the pickups. Mick's a mate of mine. He winds a lot of my pickups as well. P90 in the front and 52 T-style Telecaster pickup in the back. The bridge is a compensated Callaham bridge with that lovely little bit cut out there so you don't cut your hand when you're doing this. 500k pots, Cluson style or Cluson machine heads, vintage. Built for a fella here in Victoria called Joe Ransom, and it sounds the six, I think. Here it is through the vibrato channel of Achilles Vibraverb. Vibralux Reverb. I can never say that in one hit. Vibralux Reverb replica. The back pickup. It's just so resonant. The chambering and the Myrtle combination is just ace. The middle position. Bringing that P90 in with its extra bottom end girth really complements the twang of the 52. The combination's ace. So here's the P90 on its own. So you would think that there'd be a volume difference, but there's actually not. They're quite well matched in the volume department, but the tonal difference is enough to make it a very versatile instrument. The twang of the back. With the bluesiness of the front. Let's throw a tube screamer in front of the amp, see what the back pickup does. The neck pickup. And the middle position. It's just got so much life. These are hand-built by Ray, carltonguitars.com.au. I can't get my words out today. And of course, Ray's just reminded me that I cannot forget a very important, well, relatively small but important feature. This is a heavy-duty backplate, and it's recessed into the body, so this thing is not going to move. And I reckon that's cool. One, because there's no friction, and two, because it's as solid as it could possibly ever be. It's a very resonant light guitar. It weighs about 6 pounds, we reckon, which in the modern metric is around about 3K or less, so there's no weight to it at all and almost floats. It's very well balanced thanks to its offset design, and it is a joy to play. It belongs to a guy called Joe Ransom, who's using it in his latest video. There'll be a link at the bottom of the video. So I'm just going to whack a bit of delay on and some compression and hear what it can do for my style of playing, which is...
¶¶
And there it is, folks. Ray Carlton's, carltonguitars.com.au, Cielo Mar. Cielo Mar. I'll never get it. But it means sea sky. And it is in surf green. And I don't think I'm going to give it back to Joe, who's overseas. Luckily, it's a ripper. Check one out for yourself.